In 1977, NASA launched a historic mission to explore the outer planets of the solar system, Voyager 1 and Voyager 2. After completing their historic Grand Tour missions to Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, these two probes continued their solitary journeys toward a place where no man-made object had ever gone before, the cold and bottomless void of interstellar space. Nearly 50 years later, billions of kilometers from Earth, at the point where the sun's influence ends, they made a discovery that completely changed scientists' expectations. At the outermost boundary of our solar system, they detected a surprising structure referred to as a wall of fire. To understand the significance of this discovery, we must first define the boundary of our solar system. Our sun constantly emits a stream of charged particles called the solar wind. This wind creates a giant magnetic bubble around the solar system called the heliosphere. This bubble is a vital shield that protects us from the majority of harmful cosmic radiation coming from the rest of the galaxy. The boundary where this bubble ends and the interstellar medium begins is called the heliopause. For decades, scientific models assumed this transition would be relatively calm and predictable, like a river calmly flowing into an ocean. According to the theory, the solar wind would slowly lose its strength at this boundary and mix gently with the particles of the interstellar medium. When the Voyager probes approached this invisible threshold, this was exactly what was expected. However, the reality was far more surprising than the theory. In 2012, when Voyager 1 crossed the heliopause, its sensors recorded abnormally high temperatures. Voyager 2 confirmed this finding in 2018 when it crossed the boundary at a different point, billions of kilometers away. Both probes measured that in a narrow zone, the plasma temperature was between 30,000 and 50,000 Kelvin. This is equivalent to 54,000 to 90,000 degrees Fahrenheit and is many times hotter than even the surface temperature of the sun. This was a shocking value, far beyond expectations. So, what is this wall of fire in reality? It is not literally a wall or a fire. The particle density in the region is millions of times lower than even the most advanced vacuum we can create in a laboratory on Earth. Therefore, heat does not transfer as we know it, because there are not enough particles to conduct it. This extreme temperature is a measure of the immense kinetic energy of the particles themselves. In other words, temperature indicates how fast these particles are moving. Scientists believe there are two primary mechanisms behind this heating. The first is plasma compression. The slowing solar wind crashes into the denser interstellar medium coming from outside, causing a pileup. This cosmic collision compresses the plasma and heats it excessively. The second and more significant mechanism is magnetic reconnection. The sun's magnetic field lines and the galaxy's magnetic field lines meet and entangle at this boundary, then suddenly snap, releasing a massive amount of energy. It is this energy that accelerates the particles to these shocking temperatures. The only surprise in the data sent by the Voyagers was not the temperature. Just outside the boundary, the interstellar magnetic field was found to be surprisingly aligned with the sun's magnetic field inside the heliosphere. This was a major puzzle. Researchers had assumed that these magnetic fields, coming from two completely independent sources, would have different orientations. This was a logical expectation, but the data showed the exact opposite. This alignment suggests a deeper connection between our solar system and its surrounding galactic environment than we previously thought. One theory is that the sun's magnetic influence extends much farther than previously believed, shaping the nearby interstellar medium. An alternative explanation is that the local interstellar cloud we are in already has an organized magnetic structure, and our solar system aligns with this structure. This situation proves that the heliopause is not a static barrier, but a dynamic and turbulent interface where solar and galactic forces interact in complex ways. These findings fundamentally challenge our current models of heliospheric physics. They particularly change our understanding of how cosmic rays enter the solar system. The heliosphere is our primary shield protecting life on Earth. If this shield's boundary is more permeable and active than we thought, the amount of radiation reaching the inner system could be different than predicted. This information is critically important, especially for long-duration human space missions planned for Mars and beyond. Accurately predicting radiation levels in space is essential for the safety of the astronauts and the success of the missions. These discoveries are also shaping the design of future space missions. NASA's next-generation probe designed to illuminate this mystery, IMAP, Interstellar Mapping and Acceleration Probe, will pick up directly where the Voyagers left off. Unlike the single points crossed by the Voyagers, IMAP will map the heliopause remotely to create a global picture of the interactions at the boundary. Its advanced instruments will study in detail how the solar wind interacts with the interstellar medium, how magnetic reconnection occurs, and how particles are accelerated in this region. Furthermore, these discoveries have broader astrophysical significance. If our solar system interacts with its environment in this way, it is likely that the protective bubbles around other stars in the galaxy behave similarly. This opens a window for us to understand how star systems protect their planets from cosmic radiation and how they interact with their galactic environments. In conclusion, the enduring legacy of the Voyager mission has been proven once again. Launched in an era before personal computers or the internet, these spacecraft continue to push the boundaries of human knowledge. Although NASA has begun to shut down some of their systems to conserve energy, key instruments are expected to operate until at least 2026, and it is a matter of curiosity what other data they will send in the time they have left. The discoveries of Voyager raise more new questions than they answer. How far does the sun's influence truly reach? How does our surrounding galactic environment shape the solar system? The answers to these questions will redefine our place in the galaxy. Nearly 50 years later, Voyager is rewriting space science by revealing a wall of fire at the edge of the solar system. What other secrets await beyond the heliopause? This adventure in the cosmic ocean is just beginning.